My name is Nan Levy, and I have been living with essential tremors for roughly 12 to 15 years. It slows me down, number one, and it makes me feel that this can happen to me now. How am I going to cope for the future? This does escalate, especially since my mother had it, and it's a hereditary situation. The neurologist that I went to, he just kept saying, there's nothing more that we can do for you. Gets me down, yeah.
Nan came to me with a many year history of essential tremor. And of course it had been progressive. It's getting worse over the years. She was, like many patients, at her wit's end, looking for some relief.
When I met him, I felt so at ease, and he was easy to speak with, and he explained everything in details, answered all my questions that I had.
HiFU stands for High Intensity Focused Ultrasound. The way it works is that we're able to aim about 1,000 different small ultrasound waves towards a specific point deep in the brain. Kind of like a magnifying glass, the waves are weak in and of themselves, but where they converge at that point, the energy is very high, and we're actually creating an ablation or removing or burning those cells that are causing tremor. It's an outpatient procedure, and the patients tolerate it very well.
When I learned I had to shave my head, I had visions. I could only imagine what I would look like, and I was saying, that's going to be a little scary. I'm looking forward to a more natural way of living, be able to sit at a meal and not be embarrassed. Get so excited about it that I can hardly wait for it to happen, yes.
Nice, beautiful, I love it.
So we're gonna get a baseline of this spiral, okay? Start on the dot and stay between the lines.
This is the before, and we're about to start treatment.
So I think of essential tremor as a problem of a circuit in the brain. There's not one part of the brain that controls tremor. It's a miscommunication between many different parts of the brain. And so I think of it as a string of Christmas lights where they're kind of flickering because one of the bulbs is bad. And what we're able to do is take out that one so that the rest can light up and perform well. The results are immediate, and so they're not even out of the machine or out of the MRI room. When they start to see that their writing or their hand movements have completely changed. It can seem like science fiction because we are making a change without making any incisions. The results are so fast, and essentially we didn't touch the patient. So it can feel like science fiction, but it's real.
This is a praise. This is a high five. This is everything. Just be brave enough to say, yes, I'll do it, and go forward. And you will never regret it, never.